We have non-small cell and small cell lung cancer.
And that purely describes what the cells look like under the microscope. And so the small cell cancers tend to be ones that are more aggressive. They grow faster. They do have a typical pattern when we look at the CT scan that might make us think about small cell as opposed to non-small cell.
Some non-small cell lung cancers can grow in a way that's not a spot. They can grow more kind of in a diffuse pattern, and sometimes that can be tricky to realize that's even a lung cancer on an initial scan. Maybe we think it's a pneumonia or some sort of inflammation.
The number one cause of lung cancer still is smoking, but about 20% of lung cancers arise in non-smokers.
Unfortunately, we see that in the clinic all the time where people really say, I've never smoked, how did this happen? But there are other things that can cause lung cancer.
And this is something that we're truly fighting. And the reason is because when it presents, it's often in the advanced stage. More than 50% of the time, it's already left the lung. Lung cancer does tend to spread to areas with high blood flow. And unfortunately, that's the brain, that's the liver, that's the bone. We often see brain spread, metastases in lung cancer, in the advanced setting, perhaps in 20 to 25% or more of the patients.
And if cancer is diagnosed when they're really small, it's much more likely to be cured or at least be associated with very good survival. And that is what screening is all about. A CT scan is the best anatomic study we can get of the chest. It gives incredibly detailed information about the lungs. You know, it takes 5 minutes. It doesn't hurt. There are no needles. It's really simple.
We can guess what it is based on imaging or how it's behaved, but really it's the biopsy that gives us the answer. When you take a piece of the tumor or either the primary site or an area where it's spread and look at that under the microscope, that's what tells us the type of cancer it is.
The treatments are slightly different, and so it is really important to distinguish between them. But for both of those kinds of cancers, there are now so many more therapies available than there were even 5 and 10 years ago.
With lung cancer screening, we're finding cancer earlier. When we find it early, it gives us more options regarding surgery, regarding chemotherapy, immunotherapy, targeted therapy before surgery, or after surgery, adjuvant therapy. So progress is being made, but it requires, you know, a multimodality approach, which is one of the things we really focus on here at Yale, to have the entire team working together to combat this disease.
Most patients with lung cancer need more than one kind of doctor. So we put all that together because it's become clearer and clearer that as we have more discovery and patients have more options for therapies that will prolong their life, someday cure them maybe, you need a team of people to help you through this. You can now bring the questions from the bedside to the scientists at the bench. This is the issue. Can you find a solution for this problem, this patient, this tumor?
There has been so many examples in the last few years of how basic science research, research that's developed in the lab, now is impacting patients. We could never have used targeted therapies as successfully as we are now without understanding the mutations, the drivers of the lung cancer. And that was only something that could be learned in the lab by studying biopsies and then developing the drugs to treat those best.
But as good as the targeted therapies are, I would say the immunotherapy is even better. We can actually reactivate the immune system to target cancer.
Now they don't work for everyone, and that's a big part of research now is understanding why certain immune therapies or certain targeted therapies work for some people and not others.
And that's what keeps me up each day, trying to figure out what else can we do, you know, how can we bring new therapies to bear.
But it's those discoveries in the lab that lead to the medicines that then we study on clinical trials. And that's really the continuum of how we advance science, advance patient care, and help people live better and live longer.